Welcome to another video about Dolphin Master. My name is iSimulate. I explore different simulation games and share gameplay videos of those I like. Subscribe to my channel if you're also a simulation game lover. Continuing from where we left off in the previous episode, it's time to buy the adventurer's table. To organize a wine tasting event and bring 30 rare guests to our tavern, we need 10 pieces of cheese and the corresponding recipe, which we are only one quest point away from unlocking. Here, we have a quest that says serve only main courses for the whole day. Whenever we receive this kind of quest, we need to remove the unwanted dishes from our menu before we start the day. Business looks good and we make some money. Now, we can send our adventurers to gather ingredients. We want cheese. 3 adventurers will guarantee success. Please start. That was the day we served main courses only. In addition to taking off a quest, we have also leveled up a dish. That's great! And we should not forget to put the other dishes back onto the menu. Okay, the adventurers have brought back the cheese we need. We can schedule a wine tasting on the following day. In my other playthrough, I made the mistake that after I unlocked this new recipe, I offered it on the menu right away. Unaware that every dish served consumed one piece of cheese, I end up not having enough for the wine tasting event, so I definitely should not repeat the same mistake. And here comes our first wine tasting event. After receiving 30 rare guests, we get our bonus, 300 coins. Repeating the same steps, we organize a work anniversary event as well as the battle victory celebration. Work anniversary gives us 50 rare guests, while battle victory celebration gathers 40 gold customers. They greatly help us progress through the research tree. You may have noticed I have rearranged things in the tavern. I want to have both the bar and kitchen counters in the center, so as to shorten the overall distance our waitresses have to walk. Now, we have also unlocked the props for soup. They are the chopping board, basin, cauldron, and spice shelf. It's time we upgrade our kitchen and start offering soups on the menu. I also try to arrange the kitchen in a way that our chefs do not need to walk so much. The adventurer's table I put at the back, as where the adventurer's seat is not so important. They should go out as much as possible to gather ingredients. I put the musician podium near the center, allowing every table to enjoy good music. As we continue ticking topics off the research tree, we come across items that do not only ask for different types of guests, but research points also. After we finish this researcher's topic, I'm making this corner our research office. It will be the workplace of our researcher, Johnny. It turns out we don't only have visitors during the day. At night, someone also visits and steals one of our barrels. After this incident, the option to hire a guard becomes available. Let's take Sterling. We will have to upgrade his gears when we have the coins. And our guard successfully fends off the thief. Cool! You cannot steal from us anymore. I'm quite happy about how the ground floor looks at the moment, and it's good to see that money keeps flowing in. The rest of the space within the plot is reserved for hotel rooms. Before we complete that hotel research item, we unlock the option to build a second floor. My plan is to have the tavern look more and more luxurious as one climbs further up. That's something for our next episode. Going back to our hotel plan, finally, our researcher has completed this topic. I cannot wait to build our very first hotel rooms. Let us now make 6 rooms. We should be able to meet all the 2-star requirements. Every room is 32 tiles big. These include a 2-star bed, a 2-star wardrobe, 1 decorative item, and 1 light. Price for each room is now 45 coins. Our waitresses now have one more task, that is room service. Since we have 1 bar and 1 kitchen on the ground floor, we have 5 waitresses serving this floor. 3 of them focus on serving drinks, while the other 2 on food. Now I ask one of them, who was given a priority on drinks, to also focus on room service. In order not to overwork her, I lower her priority on cleaning. Guests start staying in our 2-star hotel rooms. That doesn't contribute much to our total revenue, but that's a start. In my next video, I will organize the other events and build more floors to our tavern. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video as well as the game. Stay tuned and enjoy Tavern Master. See you next time. Take care.